What's up, nerds? I'm Wes, Nevermore Gaming, and today we're going to learn how to play Runes of Mars by Atheris Games. It'll probably become pretty evident once we get into this how to play video, but this is a prototype of the game, which is currently seeking funding on Kickstarter. So when you get a hold of this game, it'll probably look pretty different, have much nicer components, and there may be some slight rule changes, so definitely check the rule book. But especially for the purposes of the Kickstarter, this video will definitely give you an idea of how to play this game. So to start setup, you're going to place your planet board and your language board in the middle of the table. You're going to get all 11 action tiles, give them a good shuffle, and then place them out along the planet board. Each spot gets 2 action tiles, and the wasteland gets 3, and this is done randomly. Each player is going to get a player board, a tech board, 5 language markers in their color, and 4 resource markers. Go ahead and put the resource markers on the 0 spot of your player board. And you're going to place all 5 of your language markers along the bottom of the language board. Make sure that your tech decks are well shuffled by level. You're going to deal out the top 4 cards of each deck next to the oxygen cost track, creating your available pool of cards to purchase. You're going to create a pool of radiation tokens and hourglass tokens, dealing 3 hourglass tokens to each player. Players can then choose or be dealt out a character card, and all you have to do left is assign the first player rover. In this game, players are taking on the role of researchers who have found some ancient runes on Mars, and they are trying to decipher languages and learn how to make new technologies. And to gain victory points, whoever has the most victory points at the end of the game wins. The game is over when either 4 languages have been mastered or a player has built their 9th piece of technology. And you definitely need to watch out for the radiation because these are negative victory points at the end of the game. There are some ways to heal them throughout the game, but it's definitely something to be wary of. You do not want to stack up too much radiation. So the first thing you're going to do in this game is pick which of the 5 locations on Mars you're going to place your rover. And now on subsequent turns, the next player is going to move the rover to the location that they want to take their action at. And you can leave the rover where it is. So let's say I go to the workshop on the next turn. Tom also wants to go to the workshop, so he can move the rover to the same location that I already had it at. And you can see that some of these locations have little radiation tokens at the top of them. Wherever you place your rover, you are going to take that many radiation tokens. When you're picking locations, it's really important to pay attention to what action tiles are underneath that location, because those are going to determine what this action actually does. These tiles tell you what resources, languages, and bonuses are available at that site during this turn. They are going to move around during the game, but there always has to be at least 1 action tile at every location throughout the game. At the end of your turn, they are going to shift, but we'll get into that in just a little bit. Now, before you do actually activate the location, you can transfer an adjacent tile. And what you'll do is you'll spend either 2 hourglass tokens or 2 of your oxygen, and you can move a tile from an adjacent spot to your current spot. So right here, I'm on the workshop. I can move one of these tiles from the dormitory over, or one of these tiles from the laboratory over, if I spend, again, the 2 time tokens or the 2 oxygen. You can never leave no spot. So like, let's say right now the laboratory only had this one. I couldn't transfer this one over because that would leave the laboratory with no action tiles. And no, you can't mix and match oxygen and hourglass tokens. You have to spend 2 hourglass tokens or 2 oxygen. So the first thing you're going to do during the action step of your turn is count up the wrench tokens on the action tile and use them to activate the wrench bonus of the location you went to. Like right now in the workshop, there are 2 wrenches on these tiles, so we're going to get to activate this bonus twice. And the wrench bonuses at the laboratory, for each wrench, you can get either 1 fuel, 1 parts, or 1 plan. At the workshop, you can advance 1 space on any one of the language tracks per wrench token you have. At the dormitory, you gain 1 oxygen per wrench token. And at the infirmary, you remove 1 radiation token from your player board and return it to the supply. At the wasteland, there is no wrench bonus. Once you finish with your wrench bonus, you either take the action of that site or you can take a research action. You can see there's two different types of actions in the top of these slots. The two arrows are decipher actions and the two boxes are discover actions. For the discover actions, you're going to gain one resource for each resource shown on the action tiles. So for the workshop, we're going to take a discover action and we're going to gain two plans, which are the green icons, and two parts, which are the yellow icons. So let's say instead of going to the workshop, we had gone to the laboratory and these tiles were actually over here. We could pay two oxygen or two hourglass tokens to move this tile over. So there's four tiles here. We would get our wrench bonus, which there's two of, so we could activate this twice. And since we are now deciphering, you're gonna go ahead and move up on the language track for each icon listed here. So we're gonna move up one on the red track, we'll be the red player in this example, move up two on the yellow track, one, two, move up one on the green track, and then move up two on the blue track. Even though players can share spaces on the language track, only one player can occupy each of the capstones or the top of each language. It is important to know that you can only master as many languages as level 3 tech cards that you've purchased. And since you can only have up to 3 level 3 tech cards, you can only master at most 3 languages. And if you were paying real close attention, you may have noticed that I didn't really address this action tile with the two brown icons on it. Well, this one acts kind of fancy. If you are taking a discover action and you're getting resources, these are both wild resources. So you get to pick which of these resources you want. If you're taking a decipher action on the language track, there's actually a specific language for this icon. This language is worth a lot more points, but it's a lot harder to master because there's only one tile out there that will let you advance on that track. And if you do decide to take the research action instead of the location action, you're gonna gain one hourglass token per action tile at that location. So right now at the laboratory, if we took the research action, we would gain 4 hourglass tokens. And as you may have noticed, if you do happen to go to the wasteland, you get to take a discover action and a research action, but there's no wrench bonus and you do take 3 radiation for going to the wasteland. And once you finish taking the action of your turn, you can move on to replicating one piece of tech. Now the cost of the tech is located at the bottom and you can see it costs a number of parts, fuel, and plans that you will move down on your player board. And notice there is an oxygen cost for each card if you do purchase it from the pool. So the bottom row of cards cost 0 oxygen and then 1 oxygen and 2 and so on. And if you do decide that you don't want to buy any of the available tech, you can pay 4 oxygen to pick a deck and dig through it and then pick out exactly which technology you want to build. Once you've picked your piece of technology and paid the needed cost, you can go ahead and build it on your tech board. You can build level 1 cards at any time. To build level 2 cards, you have to have reached the A space on at least 2 different languages. And to build the level 3 card, you have to have reached the A space on 2 languages and the B space on 1 language. Now, it is important to know that if you've reached the B space on a language, you've also reached the A space. So once you've reached the B, that language also counts as reaching an A. So if you have a B on one language, you only need to have one more A on a different language. If you do purchase a card from the lineup, you will then move all the other cards in that column down and reveal the next card in that column. Once you've purchased tech and you place it in your tech board, you can choose to put it in any available column. And once you've built level 2s, you don't have to have built a level 1 to place that level 2. Some cards you purchase do have an immediate one-time effect, which you'll take as soon as you've built it. Other cards give you an additional action or an additional thing that you could spend time tokens on. And some cards are worth end of game scoring points once the game is complete. Once your action is done, you're gonna reallocate the action tiles at the location you visited. So you're gonna take all of the action tiles at that space, go ahead and shuffle them up, and then place them out Mancala style, starting at the location that you activated, so that there is one
action tile remaining at that location, and the rest distribute across the board. If you get to the end and you still have tiles remaining, you're going to wrap around back to the wasteland and continue placing from left to right until you don't have any more left to place. Once your action tiles have been placed, you're going to go ahead and hand the rover to the next player, and they're going to start their turn. The game ends when a player builds their ninth piece of technology, filling their tech board, or when the fourth language is mastered and there are four tiles at the top of the language board. Once end of game is triggered, every other player gets to take one final action before the game is over and final scores are tallied. We'll score the language track first. On each of the five language tracks, each player scores the printed points on the space their markers occupy. Next, we'll calculate bonuses on complete rows of your tech board. Any row that's not complete does not score. You get 9 points for rows with tech of the same type, so B, B, B. You get 6 victory points for rows of all different types, so B, A, D. That would score 6 points. This doesn't score anything because we're missing one, but let's say we had this A here. So they're not all the same type and they're not all different types. Every completed row that doesn't fulfill either one of those conditions will score 3 points. And note, you don't get anything for completed columns. And last, we're going to calculate the negative points that each player gets for their radiation tokens. Whichever player has the most radiation tokens loses 2 points per token, and every other player loses 1 point per token. If there is a tie in overall score, whichever tied player has the least amount of radiation is the winner, and if there's still a tie, the tied player with the most total points from progress on language tracks is the winner. And that is how to play Ruins of Mars. If you want more information on this game, definitely check out our Kickstarter preview we made. There will be a link down in the description box below or a card popping up. And hey, also check out the Kickstarter page. Definitely look through that, watch some of the other videos. This game is a lot of fun, and I think you guys should definitely consider backing it. Either way, make sure you subscribe to our channel so you'll never be bored. Question of the day. How obvious is it that we don't actually wear pants when we film these videos?